Hello students, I am R.B. Sukhsare from MTT department. The subject is machine tool design. We will see a problem on spindle and spindle support, that is fifth unit. Here the main theory part is, first one, the function of spindle. Here the main important function is, first one, the centering the workpiece. Okay, the following important main points functions are, first one, centering the workpiece. That is, example is lathe, boring machine, turret, cutting tools, drilling machine, milling machine, etc. Second one, that is main function is clamping the workpiece or tool, that is clamping the workpiece or tool. Okay, that is, the cutting tool is reliably held in position during cutting operation. And third one, imparting rotary motion in a lathe or drilling machine, etc. That is the operation capability of a machine tools in terms the productivity as well as accuracy and finish of the machine parts. Okay, and then the main important materials, that is normal accuracy carbon steel. And second one, normal accuracy low speed induction, that is Rockwell is 50, and here the Rockwell is steel is 30. And third one, the spindle alloy steel having Rockwell, alloy steel having Rockwell 56 to 60. That is the materials, important materials. Okay, it is some important theories. And here let us start to the problem. How to solve the problems on spindle and spindle supports. Here first problem. Here, listen here carefully. A solid spindle of dia is 60 mm. Okay, here the diameter is 60 mm. Is loaded as shown in figure. Here the figure is there. Okay, spindle figure. Okay, the stiffness of front and rear bearing are 1.5 × 10⁵ newton per mm square and 1.1 × 10⁴ newton per mm square. Okay, and here it is a front. Okay, and it is a rear stiffness. Okay, and here the both front and rear bearings, that is 1.5 is a front, and then 1.1 × 10⁴ newton per mm square, it is a rear bearings. Okay, that is the front. Okay, here K and KB. Okay, it is a front, means what? KB. Okay, and it is called as 1.5. It is a front. Okay, it is a front. AB. Okay, it is a stiffener, it is front KB. How much? 1.5 × 10⁵ newton per mm square. And rear means what? KA. Okay, stiffness, rear means what? It is front and rear. Front, it is a front, and rear is rear. 1.1 × 10⁴ newton per mm square.
okay, it's a stiffness, right? And the bending moment coefficient, bending moment of coefficient, okay, K is equal to 0.3, okay, stiffness, okay. And assume E is means Young's modulus is equal to 2 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square, Young's modulus, okay. And load here, find the displacement at A and B deflection spindle axis due to bending Y1, okay. It's a bending spindle axis due to bending Y1. You first you have to find out Y1, okay. First you have to find out Y1 of spindle due to complex of support Y2. Spindle due to complex of support Y2. You have to find out Y2 and total deflection Y, that is Y1 plus Y2, that is the Y, total deflection, okay. And here the load, here the load P1, okay, goes to downward side, okay. Load is act on downward, here the mark is downward side, that is P1, how much, 1500 newton, okay. And P2, it is a 2200 newton, P1 and P2, okay. First you have to find reaction force R and R B, okay. Let us start reaction force solution. It is a solution. First you have to find Y1, Y2 and then Y. It's a total deflection Y. Okay. Previously you have to find first you have to reaction force R and RB. Okay. Total deflection it is a. Okay. Total solution it is a total deflection. Total deflection force RA and RB, okay. It is a formula is P1 plus P2 is equal to RA plus RB, okay. It is a formula, okay. P1, P1, P2, it is a load, reaction force RA and reaction force RB, okay. And first you have to find out reaction force RA, RA, okay. And here the already given in diagram as shown in figure, okay, means what, it's a total length is 70 plus 260 plus 70 means what, how much, 260 plus 140, 10 400, total length is 400, total length it is, it is total length is 400 mm, okay. And first what it is, left support A, stiffness A, B, C, okay. And here distance is 70 mm, one P2 load, B stiffness supporting B, and C free end cantilever, okay, that is P1, 1500 newton, okay. First you have to find out RA, okay, RA, reaction force A, okay. And here formula is, listen here, P2 into B, load is P2 into B, okay. Here P2 into B, P2 into B minus P1 into C, minus P1 into C divided by L. L means what? L, it is a plus B. It is A plus B. That is L. Okay. is equal to. Okay. P2 load P2 into distance is B minus P1 load P1 is P1 into C. Distance is length is C divided by L. L means what? A plus B. Okay, clear it? Okay, next one. P2 load, how much? 2200. Okay. Into distance B. B how much? 260. Minus P1, 1500. 1500 into C is 70 mm. C is 70 mm. Divided by length L. L is 330 mm. Okay. And its result is calculation. Okay. We can use it in scientific calculator. And its answer is how much? 1415. Already discussed in previous class. Okay. 1415.15 newtons. Okay. Okay. You find in RA, reaction force A. Okay. You first you have to find RA. Okay. And then RA. You got RA. And then P1. You know P1, P2. You know. And then already next you find out RB. Okay. You know P1, P2 and RA. Okay. Automatically you will get RB. RB. Okay. Yes. You know RA. Okay. P1 plus P2. P1 plus P2 is equal to RA plus RB. Okay. P1 how much? 2200 plus. Sorry. P1 how much? P1 how much? 1500. Okay. P1 how much? 1500 plus P2 is 2200 is equal to P1 is 1500, P2 is 2200. Okay. And RA is 1415.15 newtons. RA is 1415.15 plus RB. Okay. Okay. Next, you substitute RB. Okay. RB is equal to. RB is equal to how much? You have to calculate. This total, this one. And minus this one means what? Here RB is 2285 newton. Okay, already discussed in classes. Okay, 2285 newtons. Okay, it is RB. Okay, and then you find out RA and RB. Okay, next, first one you find out Y1, that is finding next one. Already you know first one load P1 and P2 and then reaction force RA and then RB. Okay, next step is you find out Y1. Y1 means what? Finding deflection of spindle axis due to bending Y1. Okay, finding deflection of spindle axis due to bending Y1. Okay, that is formula is Y1 is equal to 1 divided by 3 EI into bracket P1 C square into bracket L plus C minus 0.5 P2 A B C A into B into C into bracket 1 minus A divided by L bracket complete minus MR into L into C bracket complete. It is a Y1 formula. Okay, once again I will tell you Y1 is equal to 1 divided by 3 E into I, Young's modulus, moment of inertia, P1 C square into bracket L plus C minus 0.5 P2 ABC. ABC means what? It is a distance. Okay. ABC into bracket 1 minus A divided by L. L means what? L means what? A plus B. Okay. Minus MR. Okay. MR means what? Reactive bending moment. It is called as reactive bending moment. MR. Okay. L is a length. C is a distance. That is a C. ABC. That is ABC. ABC distance. This one A distance. This one B distance. This one C distance. Okay. Put this values. Y1 is equal to 1 divided by 3EI. First you have to find out I. Okay. And MR, okay, because we don't know moment of inertia I and MR, okay, reactive bending moment, okay. First, you have to find out MR, finding MR, that is reactive bending moment. I will write you, reactive bending moment. I will write here reactive bending moment. Reactive bending moment. Okay. MR is equal to, its formula is M into K. M into K. Okay. M means what? Bending moment at the support. M means what? Bending moment. At the support. Bending moment at the support. Okay. MR. MR means what? M into K formula. Okay. First you have to find out M. M means what? Bending moment at the support. M means what? M formula is. Okay. M formula is reaction force A. RA into L. RA into L. L means what? Distance minus load P2 into B plus load P1 into C. It's a formula. Okay. Here the diagram is there. Okay. RA into L. Okay. Means what? The reaction force RA into L. L means what? In A plus B. Okay. Minus P2 into B. P2 into B plus P1 into C. Okay. It is a formula. You find out M. M is equal to RA. What is value? RA 1415.15. Length is 330 minus 2200 into 260 plus load is P1. P1 means what? 1500. P1 value 1500 into distance is 70. Okay, that is M is equal to, it is substitution the calculation and then the final result is minus 50 newton per mm. Already discussed in your class. Okay, previous class. Now next MR. MR means what? M into K. It is a formula. M into K. M is minus 50 into K is still value K. K is 0.3. Okay. K is 0.3. That is coefficient. K is 0.3. That is the value is minus 15 newton millimeter. Okay. It is MR. Okay. And then solids. This problem is solid spindle. Okay. That is formula. I. Moment of inertia. I. It is formula is 5 into D raised to 4 divided by 64. Okay. That is the answer is diameter. Diameter how much? 60 mm. Okay. Diameter is 60 mm. Okay. That is the value is how much? Now is 6,36,172.51 mm^2. Okay, you find out I, this one I. Okay, you got I MR. Okay, I MR, you know L, you know C, A, you know L, A, B, C, P2 is there, P1 is there, C is there, L, C. Means what? Everything is okay. Okay, and then Y1 is equal to 1 divided by 3 into E. How much? 2 into 10 raised to 5. E is 2 into 10 raised to 5. E is 2 into 10 raised to 5. Into I. I have more, how much? 6,36,172.51. Okay. 3 EI. Okay. Completed. Next bracket complete. P1. P1 how much? 1500. Where it is P1? P1 load. 1500. Okay. Into C. C how much? 70. Distance it is. Okay. C distance. Into bracket. L is 330 plus 70, C is 70 minus 0.5 into P2 is how much? 2200 into A how much? A how much? 70. A is 70. Yeah, A is 70 into B. B is 260 into C is 70. Okay. Into bracket 1 minus A is 70, L is, L how much? 330. L means what? A plus B. Okay, A plus B, 330. Into bracket minus into bracket MR how much? MR minus 15. Here already one minus is there, next minus 15. Okay, that's why I have taken bracket. Into length is how much? Length L, A plus B means what? A plus B, 330. Okay, L is 330 and C also 70. C is 70. Bracket complete. Okay, and then you will get Y1. Okay, already you have to first you substitute this one and then you completed this one. Okay, and then finally Y1 you will get 4.81 into 10 raised to minus 3 millimeter. Okay, that is 0.00048 mm. Okay, minus 3 is there. Y1, first one Y1. Okay, now next chapter Y1. Okay, then you have to find Y2. Next one you have to find Y2. Y2 means what? Deflection of spindle due to compliant spindle support. Y2. Okay. Y2 means what? Deflection of spindle. Of spindle due to compliance spindle support. Spindle support. Okay, that is Y2. Y2 means what? Y2 formula is delta B into bracket 1 plus C by L plus delta E into bracket C by L. It's a formula Y2. Okay, Y2 means what? Deflection spindle due to compliant spindle supports. Okay, Y2. Okay, first you have to find out delta I. Okay, delta I. You know C, you know L because distance it is. Okay, C, L, you know. Okay, delta B and delta I you have to find out. Delta I is formula is reaction force A divided by stiffness of A. Okay, front and rear stiffness. Okay, it is a rear, it is a KB is a front stiffness. RA how much? Formula one values 1415 divided by 1.1 into 10 raised to 4. It is the value is 0.13 mm. Okay, next one delta B. okay, delta V, or V divided by KV, reaction force B divided by stiffness of front, it is, okay. How much value? 2285, it's the answer value, and KV is 1.5 × 10⁵, its value is 0.015 mm, okay. You put values Y2, okay. Y2 is equal to 0 delta V. Delta V how much? 0.015 × 1 plus C how much? 70 divided by L how much? 330 into bracket complete plus delta A how much? 0.13 bracket complete into bracket C by L, right? 70 divided by 330 bracket complete, okay. That is Y2. Y2 everything is substitute and then get value is 0.045 mm, okay. And then you have to find, you know, Y2 and Y1, okay. And then your total deflection is Y, therefore total deflection, total deflection Y is equal to Y1 plus Y2, okay. Y is equal to Y1 is 0.0048 plus Y2 is 0.045, okay. That is the value is Y is total deflection is 0.0478 mm, okay. It is a completed of total deflection of spindle, okay. And then another one problem is there, that is only given data and then you draw this diagram, okay. How to draw this diagram, okay. I will tell you.